Wow, it's sweet potato methi fry. To prepare a sweet potato methi fry, you require a very few ingredients, but it will come out to be a beautiful recipe to serve with roti or rice. We'll give a start. To prepare a sweet potato methi fry, these are the ingredients which you require. For tempering, I have taken mustard seeds and asafoetida, half a spoon, and jeera seeds of 3/4 spoon. Salt as required, and these are the masalas. I have taken 3/4 spoon of chili powder and half a spoon of turmeric powder, garam masala and jeera powder. I have taken 4 spoons of tamarind juice. I have taken 2 cups of diced sweet potato, also half a cup of potato and 3 cups of finely chopped methi leaves. Start with methi leaves. First, you need to add generous amount of salt to it and give a nice mix so that it will release all the bitterness in the methi leaves. Give a nice mix to it. Leave it for 15 minutes aside. By that time, we can prepare the other things to the recipe. In a pan, add 2 cups of water. To this, add potato first, then you add the diced sweet potato. The reason why we add sweet potato to the potato is potato will help the sweet potato not to get overcooked. That is the reason we add both. Look at it, it's almost cooked. We can see the color change in the sweet potato and the potato. Now we will shift it to a container and we will start to fry these sweet potatoes and potato for our methi fry. Wow, it's look seriously colorful and so yummy. I can't just wait to prepare it. Here is the methi leaves. Squeeze it nicely so that all the bitterness of the methi will be released. 3 cups of methi leaves will turn to be 1 cup of methi leaves after all its bitterness is being released. It's all ready, now we'll give a start. To a pan, add 2 tablespoons of ghee and 2 tablespoons of oil. Now add the tempering ingredients, that is mustard seeds and ink or asafoetida. Now you add the jeera to it. Once it's get nicely tempered, you can add the jeera to it. We are adding jeera. Once it gets nicely tempered, we'll add the aloo and sweet potato which has been nicely cooked, half cooked. Wow, it's so colorful. Stir it occasionally so that all the oil will get absorbed by the sweet potato and it will get evenly cooked and crispy. Occasionally be stirring. Do not close the lid. Let it be in the high flame. As it is a non-stick pan, it will not catch the vegetable. It is getting almost crisp. We need to fry it for some more time. Wow, look at it now, it's almost completely crisp. We can add the masala ingredients to it. It's so crispy and so yummy. It's almost done. Now we'll add the methi to it. Mix it well so that the methi and the sweet potato will get nicely evenly mixed. Do not stir too hard or else the sweet potato or the potato may get smashed or cut into the pieces. It's a very simple recipe, but the taste will be yummy. So less time to prepare, and you can enjoy it with roti, pulka, or dosa, or just the hot rice with the ghee. It has been nicely minced, and also the methi is being cooked for some time. Now we'll add the masalas to it, also the salt. Add required amount of salt. Add little bit less salt, as we have already added little bit salt to remove the bitterness. Add all the masala together and give a nice stir to it. You can also add chopped green chilies if you want bit more extra in the chili flavor. Give a nice stir. You can reduce the flame till you mix it nicely. Add tamarind juice. Tamarind juice will give you an awesome taste. Do not skip tamarind juice and add the lemon. Actually, a tamarind juice will be beautiful in taste. Wow, the color has changed. Now you add the jaggery in the last. Jaggery is always optional. You can skip it up if you don't want it. Mix it well. It's almost ready. We'll just mix it in a low flame for another 3 to 4 minutes and it will be ready to serve. It looks yummy. Trust me, yummy, tasty, beautifully aromatic. Enjoy, like and subscribe.